So all your friends are making these super cool AI-generated images using ChatGPT. In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to do it. It's so simple, but there are a few glitches that you could run into. We're going to walk through how to create the great images, how to get past the glitches, and how to make all your friends envious, and quite frankly, how to get your ads to convert at a higher rate. Let me share my screen. All right, so step one, you're going to open up ChatGPT, and you're going to select 4.0, and I like to start by uploading a picture of me. You can just write from your phone. I'm doing this from my computer, but first we're going to start by uploading a picture, and this doesn't necessarily have to be you. It could be anyone or anything. We're going to talk more about that later in this video, but upload a picture of you and then go ahead and type in some text, and I'm going to always ask it to please generate an image. That's the best way to start. Generate an image. I always say please, of course, because hey, we want to be polite. Please generate an image of me working with a client to optimize their YouTube marketing in Ghibli style. Now, I'm going to walk you through a bunch of different styles because you could do so many cool things, but we're going to start with Ghibli because this is one of the most popular formats, and we're going to hit go. All right, so a couple moments have passed, and we have our image. And I don't know about you, but I think this looks pretty cool. It's me. It says YouTube marketing on there. Pretty awesome. And I think that there's a lot of different ways that you could leverage this. What I can also do is be more specific about where we're at as far as location goes. Who is the person I'm speaking to? So let's play with this a little bit. I want to show you what's possible. All right. So what we're doing here is we're giving it more context. And I say, great, let's change this up and put me with an older male CEO of a company. We're both wearing suits and in the executive suite of a high-rise overlooking Tampa Bay, and let's hit go. All right, and our image is complete. You can see it executed exactly what we asked for. I'm always taking a quick look at fingers because sometimes you'll error out and get like six fingers or some weird stuff, and just simply ask it to correct it, and it does a good job of that. But you can see this, I can download it. I can take a screenshot right with my phone. One of the problems, one of the glitches you might run into is that this downloads in a very strange format. Typically here it's a PNG, but if you're downloading it from your phone, it's going to download it in a weird WEPG format. What I like to do is just take a screenshot with my phone, crop it, and then it's ready to be posted. If you're working with a digital artist, digital agency, also the same thing applies. Anyway, you can see this is pretty cool. Now, there's all sorts of different things we can do. We can kind of play with the art style. So this is a Ghibli format, which is incredibly popular. I'm going to show you some more examples. But I want to show you another example and just say, hey, let's make this in a more realistic format. Now, I'm always a little bit hesitant to go in a more realistic style. I find when we're leveraging other types like Ghibli or South Park or Cartoon Network or things like that, it could come out a little bit better. But that's something that I've noticed. Now, here's one of the errors that you'll run into. And it says, we've run into a problem due to rate limits on image creation. This has been a huge problem the last few days because everyone is using it. It says, you'll need to wait about 5 minutes before I can generate another one. Once you're ready, which is now, we'll get back to it. Now, one of the things that you'll notice is sometimes it can get stuck in this, need to wait, in which case, just open up a new chat and start fresh. It's not optimal because you need to start your chat fresh, but that's something you can do. I'm gonna show you some more examples of different styles that you can use. So here's a client of mine who we do content for, YouTube optimization, social media, et cetera. And I uploaded a couple pictures and I said, hey, make him into an action figure. Boom, action figure, just like that. Now, I said like, I want him to be in the box, still in the box, and it recreated it. So this is a really cool thing you can do. You can make yourself an action figure. You can tell it different sorts of accessories that you like, maybe like exercising, maybe like coffee, maybe you like video gaming, maybe you like playing sports, maybe you like shopping, whatever you like to do, you can say these are the accessories and you can make some really cool action figures of yourself, right? Pretty cool. Larry also happens to be super buff. And I said, let's make him into a Street Fighter video game style graphic. And it put this together, which I just think is so, so cool. We're not going to get into this video, but what you can also do is you can take images like this. You can upload them into other programs like Sora or Runway, and you can actually make them move. You can turn your still images into video, which by the way, is going to completely transform the way that advertisements and marketing work. So anyway, let's keep going and Here's another action figure. That one didn't come out well. So here's another picture of Larry with his wife. And I asked it to put them together in Ghibli format. Boom, done. And so this is kind of a cool thing you can do as well. You can just take regular pictures and transition them into this really cool style, right? I said, hey, let's put it into like a Conan Barbarian. Let's generate an image of Larry shirtless, muscular, in the style of an old Conan movie poster. And this is what it gave me, which it doesn't look exactly like him, but it's pretty dope. I said, let's generate an image of Larry in the Simpsons style. Boom. Let's do Larry in a Family Guy art style. Boom, Family Guy. Now I said, hey, give him a hat and a shirt. So you can start to see that you can use all these cool styles. Let me show you another cool style. My wife yesterday was riding her bike on the Peloton and she saw a raccoon at our front door and she freaked out. So I sent her an image. I said, I took a picture and of her. This is just in my phone. Again, you could take picture of anyone. I'll show you some more here too. These are so interesting. It says, generate an image in Ghibli style of my wife, Joanna, freaking out because a raccoon got into the house while she's on her Peloton bike. She's 35 years old, toned body, 5'10", brown hair, green eyes. And this is what it gave me. Her just yelling at this raccoon. And I said, okay, let's make the raccoon running out the door with some food. And then, you know, you can kind of play with it. But the better you are at prompting, the better your results will get. And if you need some help with prompts, not a problem. I got a free gift for you. You can go down below to aiupdate.ai. Sign up. I'll give you some free prompts so that you can really just get the best results possible right off the bat. Here's another. Generating an image of my wife fighting the raccoon in old Street Fighter arcade graphics. So it's like Street Fighter. This is so cool. I don't know. She said I'm nerding out. So here's another one where I wanted to make them fighting in Dragon Ball Z style. And there's so many styles you can do this in. Pixar style, DreamWorks style, Adventure Time, Spider-Man the Spider-Wurf style. If you can do Rockefeller style, you can do black and white, you can do pointillism. The possibilities are endless. It's absolutely, absolutely, absolutely insane. Let me give you another example here where I asked it to generate an image of an area. I said, take all the landmarks, generate it in a Waldo style. And it created this, which I think is pretty cool. The things are not necessarily placed in the right place geographically. I couldn't figure that out, but this still is kind of another cool style. I want to show you what else is possible here because this technology is very new. But what you can also do, and here's a snapshot of X, is you can draw a picture, upload it, and say, turn the sketch into a hyper-realistic YouTube thumbnail, 19 by 20. The only text that should stay during the creation process is 1,000 miles per hour, and the arrow right next to it. The rest of the text are instructions about details for you to follow. And you could just sketch this out on a piece of paper. How insane is this? And you upload that and he was able to generate this image. This person generated this image. Again, you could kind of, he says hyper-realistic, but you could use different instructions to get different results. But this is insane to me. And if you're running ad creative and running advertisements for your company, you can do this. You could create 4, 5, 10, 20. You can create ad creative at scale for A/B testing. And you can test all these different ad creatives to see what's going to convert, what's get the most clicks. This is gonna really change the game on ad creative. I'm really excited about testing this out for some of my clients because this changes everything. I'm gonna give you another example here, which I think is really cool. So I'm gonna use this same kind of text here and we're gonna create a thumbnail. So what we're gonna do here is we are gonna upload a couple thumbnails. Here's the thumbnail and here is my face. And if you want to know what the thumbnail is, this is the thumbnail that we'll be recreating. Okay, so this is a Mr. Beast thumbnail. Mr. Beast puts hundreds of thousands of dollars into thumbnails. And what we're going to do is we're going to take this thumbnail, we're going to replace his face with my face. Now, this is kind of an example of what's possible. I would not necessarily recommend you doing this, but let's play with it. Let's see what we get. And there we have it. The image is created. Isn't this just unbelievable? Now, this doesn't look exactly like me, which obviously is an issue. I probably need to play with it a little bit more, but you can see that, like, from our original image, our new image, Pretty freaking close. Pretty freaking close. And I just think this is endlessly fascinating. Another thing that we could do here is we could replace the shark with a barracuda or a turtle, and we could have me smiling. So there's different things you can do. I just think this is really fascinating. And again, will be an extremely powerful way of creating ad creative. Now, let me show you one more thing here that I think is really important that is new. And what this is consistent character design. This historically has been a real problem. So here's a picture of my daughter. I just said, hey, let me take a picture. Boom, took a picture and I said, generate an image of my 8-year-old daughter, Adeline, in the Ghibli style. And it gave me this. Now you'll note, blue bow, blue shirt with flowers on it, blue skirt. Perfect, perfect. I then generate an image of my son who's wearing this little outfit here. I said, now generate an image of her working with her brother to solve a complicated challenge. And now I think this is really important. Adeline's attire has remained consistent. So for example, if I was writing a book or designing a cartoon or designing a website, I can, all of a sudden I have consistent character design because she looks the same in these images and she has the same, outfit on. Here's them eating cookies. Prompt. Now generate an image of her and her brother baking and eating large cookies and laughing. Brilliant. I mean, it's just amazing. Now they're fighting. So that's all more common. Another thing here, the Street Fighter, I showed you that before. I also took a picture of our entire family and asked it to put that in Ghibli style. Boom, done. Also, again, it's remembered the way that Adeline looks, my daughter looks. So you can start to prompt GPTs and do some interesting stuff here, which I think is really cool. So I asked it to make me muscular and it made me really muscular. And I said, hey, let's tone it down a little bit to be a little bit more precise. So there are some really cool things that you can do with ChatGPT. I challenge you, start generating images today. Make sure you subscribe to this channel if you want more of this. And I'm going to make sure that you are generating money online, that you're staying current, and that you are keeping up with all the latest AI trends. Thanks. See you later. Peace.